If yes, in which area they are using factor analysis? Okay, and who are the final authors? And what is the total strength of the total number of paper used in the factor analysis? So what I will do, I want to search Bing researcher, because the first and foremost thing is that when you're given an assignment to do these tools or to do the research, first you go through the database and see the what are the existing content of that particular topics. Suppose I will write exploratory factor analysis. Individual, everyone. Hello. Hello.
Yes, sir. We are listening.
Yes, sir.
So when I use this term, when I saw this term, I found there are 19,414 articles already published by using the exploratory factor analysis. And if you see, the most in 2020 it is 2,900, it is 2,000, 2,000, 1,000. So on an average, 1,500 papers are published on the tools on factor analysis. And these are the prominent authors, MD and Munt. And if you see, most of the factor analysis are using the four disciplines. First, they're using in medicine, then psychology, social science, and business management. Then I'm interested to know, suppose I will just filter out the keywords to find out. Thus, I'm interested to know the factor analysis, exploratory factor analysis only. Okay, as of now. So if I limit to this, what is the outcome? There are 7,761 papers is published under this article. Okay, under these tools. And again, you have seen that most important area where factor analysis are using either medicine, psychology, social science, then computer science, and business management. So, and engineering. So the title of the factor analysis using engineering management science are justified, because factor analysis is not only used in the only management people, it is used in the both in social science, engineering, and computer science. And I'm interested to know what are the different for example, I'll go to this one, which this expert factor analysis is 5,368 paper is already there, and confirmatory 19,956. It means there is a more chance if you're using the confirmatory factor analysis, there will be publication. So the first thing is that yes, we agreed that factor analysis is huge. Engineering, management, business management, and social science. Is it clear? Hello?
Yes, sir. It is clear.
Now, if I use another terminology, just to understand, because I'm interested to know confirmatory factor analysis, how many people are using confirmatory factor analysis as of now, and whether any opportunity is available on this topic or not, let me explain. Wait a bit. Okay, there is some problem. Okay, let's start. Is it visual to everyone? The PPT?
Yes, sir.
So now the first interesting here, what I want to say to all of you, that yes, factor analysis or confirmatory factor analysis is used in engineering, management, social science, and the psychology. So it means there is a factor analysis only used in the management, not like that. So let's start. When you do any research problem, I have already explained in my last class, may retail may interested whom, research in a retail sector may. So these are my four things, four factor I want to highlight. What are the first thing? What are the factor that impact customer to visit the mall? These are my first question I want to ask. Second, can you validate the factor, or can you develop a scale so that any other retailer can also use my questionnaire or my methodology or my result. Second, can you develop a structured model of attitude measurement towards the retail mall? And fourth is, which factor impart satisfaction? So now I want to know, everyone, what is the first problem? Just interact. What is the first problem? What is the first problem? What are the factors that influence customer to visit the mall? Okay, second, can you validate the factors? Second, to develop a structural model, and four, to measure the impact of satisfaction. Now, if this is the fourth problem, now I want to find out what are the tools I want to apply to answer these questions. Anybody? But for the first research problem, which tool are going to be applied? Anybody? Any participants? For the first problem, which tool are going to be applied?
Sir, factor analysis, principal component analysis, or PFA.
For the second one? Validate.
Confirm.
Very good. Third one? It means, first one, I will apply the factor analysis, exploratory. Second, I will going to explain, apply the confirmatory, because I want to validate the factors, to validate the scale. To validate, there is a confirmatory. Okay, explore, there is a factor analysis. And develop structural model, which model I'm going to be used? Structural. And last, I want to measure the impact of satisfaction in the mall. We can use multiple regression analysis. Okay, so now let's start. What is the first step of any research? First, you have to identify the variable. What is my objective? What are the factor that impact customer to visit the mall? If this is my question, now tell me how I will find out the factors. Can I directly say the factor? Yes or no?
Literature review.
Yes, first I go for literature review. Very good. Then?
Focus group discussion.
Focus group discussion. Then?
The questionnaires.
What my first step is, I identify the variables. Because unless until you identify the variable, then it is very difficult to find out the factor. So first, I will go to the literature review. Second, I go for the focus group. Very good. What is third one? I'll go for bibliometric. Then I go for SLR. Then I'll compare all these literatures and find out the variable which is highly cited. My handwriting is somewhere near, right? Hello?
No, sir.
Variable is highly cited. Variable which is newly emerged. And variable which is related, which you think that it is fit for your study. Clear? Hello? Now what I've
done? Yes, sir.
I collected 120 research paper for my analysis. So for first paper, I identified the eight variables. Okay. The second paper, I identified 16 variables, out of which 6 are common. Clear? And third paper, when I read, I found the same thing, 24 variables, where 12 are common. So and what happened? When I reviewed all the literature, I write down here the variables. Then I write in cited. For example, what is my problem? I want to know which factor influences the customer to visit the mall. Suppose I found parking. In parking, there are 10 authors. They have cited the parking as one of the variables. Clear? Das, 2020. Ajay Kumar, 2021. Gaurav Agarwal, sir, 2018. So these are the people who already talk about parking in the research paper. So while counting, I found the total number is 10 times. These variables are not clear. Similarly, I found another one is called cleanness. Then another thing is called food court. So it means these are the factors influencing directly or indirectly the customer to visit the mall. And when I did all the literature survey, focus group, bibliometric, and everything, when taking the common out, I found these are the variable which is common in every literature review, focus group, and bibliometric, and SLR. So how many variables have I identified? Anybody? How many variables have I identified?
25.
Wonderful. These variables are directly or indirectly influencing the customer to visit the retail mall. Clear? Parking, safety, security, events, game zone, cleanliness, spacious, international brand, like these. Now, what is the objective? Can I recommend all 24 variables to the management to develop your strategy? Is it good?
No, sir. We have to reduce the dimension.
The first thing is the management is interested to know, give them some factor, because it is very difficult for them to apply each and every variable for their strategy point of view. So it means there are some correlation, there are some relationship within the variable. Without applying the factor analysis, can I say parking? Hello, parking, security, okay, space. These are can be one factor. Am I right or not?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. You can assume, sir.
Game zone. Okay. Events, movies. These are the one. Another correlation. Brand, brand value, origin, brand pricing, brand image. So these are another dimensions. Clear? Sitting space, air condition, cleanliness, spacious. It means there are some correlated variables within my study. Is it clear? So the first thing is that I want to check, is there any correlation among the variable or within the variable? If yes, what are they? And that correlation variable, if you group together, it is called factor. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now there are two things. One is called exploratory factor, another is called confirmatory factor. In case of exploratory factor, what happened? I would use to find out the only underlying the factors. When it is a confirmatory factor, it is called validate, it is called explore. Clear? It is called validate, it is called explore. So difference is that in exploratory factor, there may be some cross-loading, but if you apply confirmatory factor, there is no cross-loading among the variable. I will explain in my study why I am applying CFA, not EFA. Now, why CFA? What is the objective? What is the objective of why you are using CFA? First is to confirm and validate. Hello? To confirm a model is fit or not. To check whether the underlying the variable is significant in that factor or it may be changed. To check the validity of the model. And fourth, to generalize the model. So these are the four basic objectives by which we are applying confirmatory factor analysis. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. It's a year and a half product or the magro.
No, जैसे सर आपको कंफर्टेबल लगे सर वैसे
सर आप मेजरमेंट कर लो सर तो व्हेन यू अप्लाई सीएफए हाउ आई विल स्टार्ट सीएफए फर्स्ट आई गो टू अप्लाई ईएफए इट्स एन अनलेस एंड अनटिल इफ अप्लाई ईएफए यू कैन नॉट डायरेक्टली गोइंग टू सीएफए द फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट यू शुड अप्लाई ईएफए देन डिजाइन सम ग्राफ using the latent variable and indicator variable through MOS. I will explain what is latent, what is indicator. Then third thing is, check the model is fit or not. Fourth thing is that, check the model is validated or not. If both the things are yes, then you can say that our scale is validated. Are you clear? So why CFA? First is, confirm the model fit. So generally in good research paper or very good journal or reputed journal, they asked both the things. If you apply only EFA, they will reject your paper. Unless if you apply EFA and CFA both, then there is a chance that the paper will be published because you have explored the factor and you have to validate the factor. And that validate can be useful by other researcher or the corporate or industry to develop the strategy. Third thing is, why SEM? So first is EFA is explore the factor. CFA is validate the factor or model confirm the factor. And third one is called YSEM. First, SEM means I have to check relations between hypothesis among the variable, latent. Second, to check the goodness of the model fit. Second, third, to measure the relationship. Fourth, to check the validity of the model and generalize. Now, simple is when you have to measure the relationship between factor to factor, that can be solved through SEM. Clear? And how can you do that? First you apply EFA, then you apply CFA, then SEM. For SEM, you cannot directly start SEM. first apply EFA, then you confirm the factor through CFA. Once factor is confirmed, then that then relationship can be measured with the help of SCM. Now, first thing is that, suppose I want to measure the relation between these two latent variables. I cannot directly give this hypothesis or measure, and you have to go through the reviews. Is there a relationship exists or not through the literature? If the relationship exists through literature, survey is found, then only you can measure the relationship. ऐसा नहीं कि मैं randomly बताऊंगा कि ये दो factor relationship है. No. First, relationship should be exist either through literature review or it is in a hypothesis developed through your focus group, whatever may be. Then, second is design the graph, check the model fit, check the validity, find out a significant impact of the value, then apply the generalization and policy making. So the policy making of the organization is based upon SCM. So when you apply SCM, what are the first step? First, identify the variable. Is it clear? Participant, is it clear? What is the first thing? Identify the
variables.
Second, apply EFA to identify the factor. Third, apply CFA to confirm the factor. And fourth, develop the model through SCM. Once your model is developed and hypothesis tested, then you develop the policy or strategy. The strategy is based upon SCM. So this is the process you have to travel from identification variable to complete your SCM. Before identification variable, what is the step? Anybody? Before identification variable, what are the step? Literature review.
Literature review.
Bibliometric.
Yes.
Analysis and SLR. So it means if you want to develop a SCM model, you have to start through literature and end with SCM. Is it clear? Any doubt after this? Hello. Because Dr. Gaurav has already explained about the factor analysis, I will just touch the minimum things of factor analysis through the some example, then I will move to CFA. So there are three steps in the factor analysis, because I don't want to explain what is factor, because already you have experienced through Dr. Gaurav lecture. So but I want to explain the basic things. When you apply the factor analysis, the three steps required. First, you have to check whether you can apply factor analysis or not. मैं फैक्टर एनालिसिस अप्लाई करूंगा कर पाऊंगा ना नहीं कर पाऊंगा. सेकंड, हाउ टू डिटरमाइन द फैक्टर एंड थर्ड, व्हिच वेरिएबल आर इंक्लूडेड इन द फैक्टर. इज इट क्लियर? हेलो.
यस सर.
क्लियर.
यस सर.
सो फर्स्ट थिंग इज, कैन आई अप्लाई फैक्टर एनालिसिस? दैट कैन बी चेक थ्रू थ्री थिंग्स: रिलायबिलिटी वैल्यू, केएमओ वैल्यू, ब्रेटलेट वैल्यू एंड सैंपल साइज. सेकंड, to determine the factor, I will depend two things: eigenvalue and community variance, and to which variable are included in the factor, I go for rotated component matrix and loading. Now see, please take the snapshot of this. But this is the most important thing. It will be used for discussion. मैं सारा चीज को एक जगह में रख चुका हूँ. What should the relative value? What should the validity value? What should the your adequacy? So I got all the things. Can I proceed now? इसको मैं बाद में आऊँगा. These are the thumbs rule. I am analyzing the factor analysis. Can I proceed now?
Sir, आप कर तो रहे हैं.
मैं बोल रहा हूँ बार बार सर, ये स्पीड हो रहा है ना, स्लो हो रहा है, इसलिए बीच-बीच में बोलता रहा हूँ.
मनोज सर.
हाँ.
You please continue. If somebody will ask question, तो आप उसका reply कर दीजिए.
Okay. So in factor analysis, these are things that require: reliability, validity, communities, loading, variance, factors, and to check factors independent or not. The first thing is that Dr. Ajay is a very is expert in reliability, so I will not take much. I darta hu ki reliability ko jab baat karta hu to start kar denge different reliability. But yes, but in our management perspective, what is reliability? For this perspective, we have to see that the data is reliable or question is reliable. What is reliable? Anybody, any judge participant, can explain what is reliable?
The data we can trust.
Suppose I have collected, I have prepared 23 variable, I identified 23 variable, I prepared a questionnaire, and I collect data from 500 respondents. And I am claiming that my questionnaire is reliable and my data is reliable. Okay, what does it mean?
Sir, consistency of results.
Consistency of results. So, professor, there are two ways to check the reliability. without factor, without expression, with expressions. Without expression, what happened? हम लोग क्या कर रहे थे during our times? We divided the whole data into two parts. Suppose we collected data in 500. So this is 250. This is 250. So divided. This is statement number one. This is statement number two. This is statement number three. And this is statement number, let me 10. So these are the information. This is respondent one to 250. This is respondent one to 250. Divided all 500 two parts. These are some variable 3, 2, 1. This is strongly agree, strong disagree. Because we have used the Likert scale. One is a strongly disagree, and five is for the strongly agree. Now what happened? I have calculated the mean value of this 250. That will be 3.86. And I calculated the mean value of next 250. It is 1.5. Second, I calculate second one, 4.1, 4.5. But tell me, which is the reliable or which is not reliable? Whether S1 is reliable or S2 is reliable?
S2 is reliable.
Why? Because there is no differences, okay, about the mean value. But here, there is, if the within 250, there is a differences, how can you claim that this statement or this data will be reliable for if you generalize the more population? So then what happened? We calculate a T value. Check the two mean. The T is significant, we can say it is reliable. If it is not significant, it is not reliable. But to avoid all these difficulties, there is a Professor Cronbank, in 1951, okay, there is a journal called Journal of Psychology, developed the concept. He says that if the alpha value is less than 0.5, it means it will be unacceptable. You just remove that data. If it is between 0.2 to 0.56, poor, but if it is greater than 0.6, okay. 0.2, 0.7, questionable. So, if alpha is, it means what he said, minimum value of alpha should be greater than 0.6 to be called as reliable. Okay. Can I say reliable value is 1? If I take the my question data, reliable value 1 RI. What does it mean? Can it be possible? Reliability value will be 1?
Sir, it might be possible, but it will show the multicollinearity. So we should, that is not a pretty desirable situation either.
Because, sir, when within one single variable, how can you say collinearity? I say this is S1 statement, and I got the coordinate, the alpha value is equal to 1. My question is, can it be possible? Alpha is equal to 1. If everybody say strongly agree, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, 5, cigarette is injurious to health. Everybody say strongly agree, strongly, all 500. Then what should be the reliability value? Hello? Sare log bolenge strongly agree, koi difference nahi hoga, three nahi hoga, sare 5, 5, 5, 5 bolenge. What is reliability value? Alpha is equal to 1?
1.
Clear, because more consistency is there. Okay, but since we are collecting data from human beings, so human being judgments always will differentiate. So what's about, so we believe there is a Cronbank alpha. If the Cronbank alpha value is greater than 0.6, then we can be reliable. Okay, but 0.8 to 9 is good, and above 0.9 is excellent. And what is the Cronbank alpha value? Lies between 0 to 1. Can it be 0? Can it be 0? Yes or no? Hello? Can alpha value consistently be 0?
Yeah, if there is data is missing.
Data is highly scattered. Highly scattered. Okay, agar main 25,000 data le raha hu and isme sara scattered mein hoga and all agar dekhunga sara sab okay, both different range, then it may be possible. But being a management researcher, we always believe that we calculate alpha value should be greater than 0.6. Second thing is that already Gaurav sir isko padha chuke hai, I don't want to take much more time. Okay, just because he hits there around. I will share this PPT to all of you. Is it okay? To apply factor analysis, what is the minimum sample size required? Hello? Is minimum 300. There are two rules. I mean, if we have 10 variable, one variable, that at least 10 observations should be there. If I have 30 variable, how much observation should take? How much I will take? 300. Suppose some researcher using 55 statement and they are only taking collect data of 285. Okay, so if you apply this type of data through this 50-way factor variable, then the result may not be valid. So to ideally the factor to apply factor analysis, 300 is the minimum requirement for factor analysis. But there are different variations. Please go through my PPT. I will share all the PPT. Then there is a called KMO. I hope it is already clear to all of you. Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Definitely is clear to all of you.
Yes, sir.
Can I proceed?
Sure, sir.
And eigenvalue is already explained by Gaurav sir. Now let me explain about the factor analysis loading is already clear. So do you want to repeat the same thing or I can proceed the next one? Hello. Any कोई भी आंसर हो तो बताओ so that I am able to understand.
Proceed, sir.
Proceed. Okay. So let me example. For reliability value, what is the minimum value required? Cutoff value required? 0.6. For validity, 0.6. For validity, sample adequacy or not, we required greater than 0.5. Okay. Bretlet for independence test, Bretlet value should be less than 0.05. Already sir ne bataya chuke hain. And sample adequacy test and eigen value should be greater than 1. Then percentage variance, minimum 60% is required. Communalities should be greater than 0.5. And for loading, minimum 0.4 is required and requiring 0.6. So let's start with one example. Main example start kar raha hu. Is it visible to all of you? Hello?
Yes, sir, visible.
Okay, now see, these are data I have used. Parking, safety, security, events, game zone, cleanliness. These are data I'm using, okay, to factor analysis. And these are respondent. This is gender, marital status, age, education, area, technical qualification. And these are the some statements I have used for factor analysis. Okay. So any doubt after this, I have collected data and I'm already used all the data into the SPSS. Now I want to apply factor analysis. What is the first step? Anybody? What is the first step? Any participant, just tell me, I will start off factor analysis. What is the first step? Because you already explained in the first class, I don't want to take much more time on that. The first step?
Go to analyze.
There is called scale.
Reliability. Yes,
sir. Click the reliability. And please select all the ordinal scale data. Okay, can you find out reliability of gender? Hello? Can I find out reliability of gender?
No.
Why? No. Because it's already reliable. Okay, these are the only nominal scale. So nominal scale data cannot be taken as reliability. We always take the ordinal scale data. Clear? Okay, just pass it. Please go to statistics. There are three things required. One is item reliability, scale reliability, and if scale, item deleted. Clear? Hello?
Yes, sir. Clear, sir.
Continue.
Yes, sir.
Continue. Click OK. Now, what is the, how many data have you used? What is the sample size? Is it visible to all of you, the output?
Yes, sir. Visible, sir.
So yes, how many, sir. What is the N size? 400?
411.
What is the clone bank alpha? 0.905 means it is a highly, what is our conclusion? The questionnaire is highly reliable because it is greater than 0.9. So according to Professor Clone bank alpha 1951, the data is consistent. Now second thing, I will check the each statement reliability. Parking, what is reliability value? 0.897. Safety, 0.898. Now I have seen all the statements also reliable. Clear? If any data of any value which is less than 0.6, please remove that variable for factor analysis. Clear? अगर मैं 55 statement लिया हूँ, उसमें देखो 8-10 ऐसा variable है जिसका value 0.6 से कम आ रहा है. So please don't use that statement into the factor analysis. Clear? This is step number one. Any doubt? Can I repeat the same thing or it is okay?
It's okay, sir.
Now, once I have convinced that yes, my factor, my statements are reliable, then I'll go to the analyze. It is called dimension reduction. Is it visible to all of you? Say yes or no. Just participate.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's visible, sir.
Now, please select all the ordinal scale which are going to be factor. Then click descriptive. In descriptive, what is our objective? I want KMO, that is for sample adequacy, and birth rate. Clear?
Continue. Yes, sir.
Then there is extraction. Already Sir talk about the wheel. There are different methods. I have to use principal component method because what do I want? If one variable is included with one factor, that variable should not be included other factor. Agar main Ajay sir ke saath dosti hu, then main aur kiske saath dosti nahi banunga. That is called principal component analysis. I will exclude that. Okay. And already Gaurav sir ne bataye the scree plot. And there are two way. Now listen, it's a very important point I want to discuss with you here. If you know the factor prior to research, then प्लीज यूज दिस कॉन्सेप्ट आस्क आई वॉन्ट फाइव फैक्टर तो क्या करेगा पूरा डाटा को पांच में डिवाइड करके दे देगा फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन आवर मैनेजमेंट कॉन्सेप्ट कॉल्ड फाइव फोर्सेस पोर्टर्स मॉडल तो पोर्टर्स का पांच फोर्स हमको पता है तो हम यहाँ पांच लिखेंगे सपोज फोर पीस प्रोडक्ट प्राइस प्लस प्रमोशन सो इफ बिफोर अप्लाइंग द फैक्टर एनालिसिस इफ यू नो द नंबर ऑफ फैक्टर इज फाइव और सिक्स और सेवन देन प्लीज यूज दिस कॉन्सेप्ट बट सिंस you don't know how many factors are there because it is a first hand research then you believe based upon eigenvalue if the eigenvalue is greater than 1 it is called factor clear continue then there is a rotation sir already explained about the Vermeer's rotation oblique rotation so click here Vermeer's rotation Vermeer's means each variable is rotated in a different factor and which is having high maximum variance that he will be considered Vermeer's rotation Continue. Then there is an option which is very important, sorted by size. Click. फिर से बता रहा हूँ. दोबारा मैं बता रहा हूँ. Go to the analyze. Go to the factor. Then select all the variable. Go to descriptive. Click KMO and Bartlett. Continue. Extraction. I want principal component, I want scree plot, I want eigenvalue greater than 1, rotation, I want Vermeer, and option sorted by size. Clear? Clear?
Yes, clear.
If you say okay, now the first thing is, what is the KMO value? What is the KMO value?
0.89.
What is the minimum value required? 0.6?
0.6
is good. So it means we clear that the sample size, whatever you taken for factor analysis, is adequate to analyze the factors. Clear? Second, Bartlett value is less than 0.05. Clear? Hello. It shows that the factors are independent. It means there is no correlation among the factor. So to check the hypothesis that factors are independent, you are using Bartlett test, and it is shown that the p-value of Bartlett value is less than 0.05. We claim that factors are independent and it is okay. So three things is required. Reliability is good. KMO is also good because greater than 0.6. And the Bartlett is also less than 0.05. It means factors are independent. Now the commonalities, that is called variance of the variable. Which is the highest one? Anybody just find out what is the highest one? Tell me the five highest one. What is the highest one? Space? Hello?
Sir, events.
Events. Events. Okay. Now the first, the consumer wants events. They are more influencing factor, a high variance. Second, they are interested for species. Third, they are interested for brand image. So it means from these commonalities, you will find the major five things what generally customer wants from the retailers. Clear? And isko kya karenge? You have to rank the from highest to lowest. So it will be clearly understood what are the percentage of variance of that particular variable, okay, into the factor. But now see, this is the more important. How many factors are there?
Five, sir.
Fine. Let me explain. May I go the car around? Already okay. Okay. Now see, this is already done. Now see, how many factors are there? Five. Because after five, the eigen value are less than one. Is it clear?
Yes.
What is the percentage of variance of factor one? 32% variance. Second, 14%.
14.
Third, 10%. What is total percentage variance?
68.8.
So it means there are five factors which impart the customer to visit the mall, and the total variance of the factor is 68. It means 32% variance are unexplained. Clear? And 68% variance are explained. Good or bad? Good or bad?
Good, sir.
Good. Next thing is that now there is, if you go to this, you go through this output. Okay. Is it clear now? This one is clear? Now the scree plot. Sir, tell me, how much? If I do 1 from here, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This 1 after this, all are coming. Clear? You can see this. This is 1. If I draw a line after 1, if I draw a line here from 1 to here, how many factors are there? 1 above the line. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 factors. Clear? There are 2 ways. One, you find through eigenvalue is greater than 1, or through scree plot. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is called, don't go for, because you apply very mass, don't go for component. We want rotated component. Now, these are the 5 things. Anybody, what is the value of this? So, kya bolte hain? Sir ne bataya tha. What is the value here? These are called? Anybody? These are called loading. These are called? Loading means correlation between the statement with that particular factor. Okay? But now see, I will go through this PPT. Is it visible to everybody? Now, first factor, kitna hua, kya kya hua? 0.8, 0.8, 0.7, 0.7, 0.7, 0.7, 0.7. Iska baad yeh down ho gaya. Clear? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Now, it means these are only one group. Clear? इसके बाद यहां से जंप कर रहा है वैल्यू यहां पर देखो 0.57 तक रह गया 0.5 मिनिमम कट ऑफ देन अगेन जंप कर रहा है यहां पर 3 अगेन इट विल जंप हियर बाकी सब कम हो गया इन कंपेयर टू दिस देन अगेन यहां जंप कर रहा है इज इट विजिबल और नॉट समझ आ रहा है
यस सर
नाउ इफ यू सी द फर्स्ट फैक्टर व्हाट आर द कंपोनेंट्स इट इंक्लूडेड ब्रांड इमेज brand pricing brand value brand quality variety of brand international brand original brand ability brand means they have high correlation so what is the name of this factor factor ka naam karan aapko karna what is the name of the factor
brand
so brand either impact while the customer visit the mall agar brands wahan available hota hai to visit kar rahe hain ye humko pata lag gaya after this the loading value is less than 0.5 but now here it is jumped What are here? Space, air condition, sitting space, parking, cleanliness, safety, security. What is the name we can call by taking the correlation of all the variable? We can say that.
Infrastructure.
Space, air condition, space, parking, infrastructure. So second factor influencing the customer is called infrastructure. What is third one? Game zone, movies, food court. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Because this value, loading value is greater than 0.5 here, and if you compare it with other statement in this factor, less than 0.5. So they are in a common one group. If you see game zone, movie, and food court, they are a highly correlated statement, correlated items. What is the name we can call? Entertainment.
Entertainment, yes.
And what is the fourth one? Events, promotion, celebrity, and specials. Clear? We can say the promotion. What is the last one? What is the last one? Bar, discotheque, gymnasium. We can say that value-added service. So what are the five factors influencing the customer in Visit Mall? Anybody?
Brand, infrastructure, entertainment, promotion, and value
services. Infrastructure, entertainment, promotion, and value-added service are majorly impacted the customer to visit the mall. And brand has high variance. What is the variance of? What is the percentage variance of brand?
32.
It means it is a high impact because it explained 32% of variance. Clear? What second one? Infrastructure is how much variance? 14.
14%.
Third one?
10%.
Entertainment 10%. Then fourth one is your promotion is 6%. And fifth one is your value service is 5%. 4%. If you are the manager, what is the strategy you can suggest to the manager? Anybody? What are the strategy you have to suggest to the manager? We said that we have to create a brand identity so that people will be more attracted towards our retail. And to create that, first I focus on brand image, then brand pricing, and create brand value. Clear? While go for infrastructure, what are the three major things I have to look for? Management, space, AC, and sitting space. In entertainment, what is the major thing I should look for? Game zone, because this is the highest loading. Clear?
Yes,
sir. In promotion, what is the first thing? I'll create the events, and the value-added service, I'll create the bar. So what are the major five things I have to look for? Create a brand image, then
think
about specials, develop the game zones,
promotion,
organize events, and try for bar. These are the influencing points to the customer. Is it clear? So, yahan to humne explore kar liye. Now, question is how to validate the things, because these are data from only 500 customers. Okay. Now, you can explain this thing in one beautiful table. Isko is tarah se likhna hai. Write down factors, write down the variable, mean value, reliability value, communities value, loading value, Eisen value. So, because if you give five or six table in your paper, then it will take much space. So how to reduce that? You prepare like this table. Any doubt up to this factor? This is called brand, this is called infra. Like this, within brand you write down the statement, write down the reliability value, amenities value, loading, what you extracted, factor of the Eisen, and factor of the variance. And in below you write down Cronenberg alpha, KMO value, and Bradley value. Clear? Now, once you got this, then you require to, what is the next one? Confirmative. Any doubt regarding exploratory factor? Any doubt? Any question? Because before going to the confirmatory, I want to know, or you want to repeat this again?
No, sir. It's not needed.
Okay. Now, second thing is called, these are called confirmatory. Now, see, in this confirmatory analysis, we have to develop an image. यहाँ पर क्या आ रहा है? एक आपका oval shape आ रहा है, clear? And एक rectangular shape आ रहा है, और एक arrow आ रहा है. These are called construct. These are called latent variable. जो नाम हमने दिए थे. These are called indicator variable. जो हमने data collect किए थे. Is it clear? Hello.
Sir, please repeat this.
Okay, now there are two type of variable generally using confirmatory, because I want to validate the factors. So there are two type of shape. One, I go for oval shape, that is called construct, or this is called the factors, and this is called indicator variable, which is the items we have collected from okay, through questionnaire. Is it clear? These are the questionnaire variable, and these are the factor analysis construct. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, for example, this is one study, eating attitudes, food acceptance, internal regulation, and contextual. Eating attitudes, there are how many statements are there in the first factor? 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Clear? So what are the five things we have explored from factor analysis? I have to check whether these all five will be feasible or can be included in this factor, or someone can be excluded. Because to validate the things, I have to check through confirmatory factor analysis. Now I will explain, these are the loadings value, I will explain one by one, and these are called Eisen values. Now, is it exploratory factor or confirmatory factor? Anybody? It is exploratory or confirmatory?
Confirmatory.
Because what happened? These are the factors. These are the items. And for each item, it is called residuals. For example, when you say y is equal to beta 0 plus beta 1 x1, and there is called e. Sarne padhaye honge aapko regression mein. Okay, errors. Okay, so this is y, this is x1, and this is e1. This is one regression line. Clear? Similarly, y, this is x2, and it's x, this error. Y, x3, it's error. Y, x4, it means this is called, we can say that simultaneous regression line. So, humko jo ek ek regression kar rahe the, we go for more simultaneous regression line. Is it clear now? This is y,
yes,
this is x1, and it's residual. This is y, this is x2, it's residual. So, now the first thing is that we have to design such type of image in our analysis. Is it a confirmatory or a exploratory? Hello. It's confirmatory. Now this is called structural modeling. Now what is the difference between this the confirmatory structural? Now see here the relationship between construct to the factor. Clear? Factor to the item. Is it clear? The item is the factor. ये हमने क्वेश्चन डाटा कलेक्ट किए थे उसका नामकरण हमने दिए थे बट नाउ हियर व्हेन यू वांट टू फाइंड आउट रिलेशन बिटवीन फैक्टर टू फैक्टर देन इट इज कॉल्ड एचसीएम एनी डाउट व्हाट इज दोनों का प्रोसेस सेम है दोनों का एनालिसिस भी कंडीशन सेम है बट डिफरेंस इज दैट नाउ हियर द एरो मार्क इज बिटवीन फैक्टर टू फैक्टर क्लियर फैक्टर टू फैक्टर सो व्हेन यू मेजर रिलेशन बिटवीन फैक्टर टू फैक्टर इट इज कॉल्ड एनीबडी इट इज कॉल्ड Hello, please. This is confirmatory. This is one confirmatory. This is another confirmatory. Oh, this is one factor, one third, second factor, and third factor. Now, what happened here? I don't want to confirm the factor. I want to find out relationship among the factor. So, what I did, I have developed relationship like this. Okay, this is called for SCM. Now, see, I will give you one example. I'll give one example so that you can understood. Now, suppose I want to measure the attitudes of the customer, attitudes towards the customer. Now, attitudes has three items. Okay, attitude depends upon intention to visit, and second is your satisfactions, or you can say that the brand image, brand. Intention visit, it depends upon three factors, and brand depends upon three factors. Now, is it factor or confirmatory or SCM? Anybody? When we want to measure the relation between factor to factor, it is called SCM. Clear?
SCM. Clear? Yes, sir.
So, is it SCM or CFA? Yes, sir. Is it SCF, CFA or SCM?
The CFA.
Now, see, this is one factor. Please remember, this is one factor. This is another factor. This is third factor. Clear? So now I want to measure the factor because I want to say that there is a relationship between hedonic motive and patronage. Hypothesis one. And there is another hypothesis I have taken, iterative motive and patronage. Now what happened? When we want to measure the relationship between construct to construct, it is called SCM. It is called
SCM.
What about this? Okay, so let's start. When you apply conformity structure, these are the three things are required. Confirm the factor, there is no cross-loading. So let me explain. I'll go to the directory graph. First, there are two steps there. One, I have designed the thing. Second, I have to estimate the thing. Third, analysis. मैं तीन चीज करूंगा, design कराऊंगा, then estimate करूंगा, then analysis करूंगा and strategy बताऊंगा. Clear? The first thing is that I have to design. How many factors derived from the factor analysis? Anybody? How many factors were derived from factor analysis?
Five.
कितने factor निकला हमने?
Five factors.
Five. Okay. Ajay sir. अभी से रिकॉर्डिंग हो रहा है ना तो इनकी बड़ी बात ओके तो लिसन प्लीज ओपन योर एमओएस दो जो आर हैविंग एमओएस प्लीज ओपन दैट सो दैट वी कैन एवरीबॉडी इज हैविंग एमओएस यस और नो
नो सर
हेलो ओके सो एक बार मैं पढ़ा लेता हूँ सीख लीजिए देन इसको वीडियो में आप यूज करेंगे एंड मेरा भी लेक्चर यूट्यूब में है रिगार्डिंग CFACM यू कैन गो थ्रू दैट फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट आई हैव टू सिलेक्ट द construct main size select kar raha hu like this okay now the second is I want to draw that graph pehla factor mein kitna statement tha let it be four there are five factors there are five factors hello Can I again? I'm going to explain. Don't worry. First, you fix a size of your construct. Then I know there are five factors. Then I have, and for each factor there are at least four variables we have explored in the previous thing. Accordingly, you design the things. क्या करूँगा मैंने? पहले मैंने construct develop किया. चार factor. एक second में भी चार factor था. थर्ड में भी चार फैक्टर था फिर भी मैं चार चीज करूंगा ज्यादा नहीं करूंगा एंड फिफ्थ में भी तीन था तो एक्चुअली मैंने क्या देन आई वांट टू डिजाइन इन सच अ वे सो एक लाइन मुझे रखना है तो देयर इज अ कॉल द टू वन वन इज कॉल मूव अनदर इज कॉल रोटेट तो फर्स्ट में क्या करूंगा रोटेट करूंगा आई रोटेट द थिंग्स देन आई वांट टू मूव ऑल टुगेदर वन Two, three, four, five. So, what is the objective? My objective is that I have to see whether the all the items should be lies in the construct or not. To check that, we have applied confirmatory factor analysis. Okay. Hello.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Now the second thing is that I have to go for the variables. क्या करूँगा? यहाँ पर एक variable नाम है. List of, go to the SIL data file. Data file जा रहा हूँ. Then go to the file name. File मेरे पास है. देखो CFA and SCM 32 variable. इसको मैंने open किया. ओपन करने के बाद ऑटोमेटिकली इफ यू गो टू दिस वन लिस्ट ऑफ वेरिएबल यहां पर आपको डाटा शो करेगा तो देन व्हाट आई विल डू आई विल फर्स्ट फैक्टर इज A1 मैं इस क्लिक कर रहा हूं मैं पुट कर रहा हूं A1 आइटम सेकेंड A2 देन A3 देन A4 वेर इज A4 A4 सिमिलर मैंने कोडिंग कर लिया सो दैट इट विल बी इजी फॉर मी B1 B2 B3 एंड B4 एंड थर्ड आई गो फॉर C1 वेर इज C1 C2 एंड C3 Okay, then I'll go for D4. Let it be D3. जो भी फैक्टर में आपका आया होगा आइटम पहले में उसको आपने कोडिंग करके यहां पर आपको अप्लाई करना है D1, D2 then D2 Then next is F. Let I will take the G H1 and H2. मैं बता रहा हूँ दोबारा एक बार. Let me K1 K2 K3 कर देते हैं. K1 K2 K3. Now see. Let me explain. First we apply the factor analysis. अपना first factor analysis जो ये था brand था. Brand में यहाँ पर मैं double click कर रहा हूँ. I will write down brand. Brand में मेरा पांच factor था तो मैं पढ़ाने के लिए चार ले रहा हूँ क्योंकि मुझे time saving करने के लिए. तो जो भी चार आपका item था इसको यहाँ पर put करेंगे. Second आपका पास infra था. उसको यहाँ पर put करेंगे. सेकेंड था आपका प्रमोशन प्रमो. फोर्थ था आपका इवेंट्स. फोर्थ क्या था आपका एनीबॉडी ब्रांड
वैल्यू
प्रमो देन
इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर.
फोर्थ वन ब्रांड इंफ्रा प्रमो देन
एंटरटेनमेंट एंड वैल्यू एडेड.
एंटरटेनमेंट
इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर
एंटरटेनमेंट then value added service.
Value added.
So what is the first step? First identify the expert factor analysis. Then accordingly you design your confirmatory factors. Okay, then for each factor how many items you have already explored. Okay, you just put that variable in this format. उसको पहले coding करेंगे तो आपको easy हो जाएगा. Otherwise image में बाहर चला जाएगा. It's not good. So now five factor I have written and within factor what are the factor we emerged. एक्सप्लोरर में आया था उसको मैंने यहाँ पर मैंने इसको फिट कर लिया.
सर
यहाँ पर एक चीज मिसिंग है.
सर सॉरी टू इंटरप्ट.
या
कोडिंग मींस सर व्हाट वी हैव टू डू फॉर कोडिंग.
नाउ सी ओके लेट मी एक्सप्लेन. अभी आपके पास ये जो आइटम था ना वेरिएबल नेम. हेलो इसको देखा जा रहा है आपको. यहाँ पार्किंग बहुत बड़ा आइटम है ना. इसको मैं लिख लूंगा ए वन. सेफ्टी आई विल राइट ऑन ए टू सो दैट मुझे पता रहेगा कि ए वन इज पार्किंग ए टू इज मतलब यही आइटम को हम वहां पर शो करेगा. और आप डायरेक्टली इसको लिखा होगे तो ये बाहर चला जाएगा कहां से वो रेक्टेंगुलर से. क्लियर.
ओके सर अंडरस्टूड सर.
ओके द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज दैट व्हाट इज द मिसिंग हियर. व्हाट इज द मिसिंग हियर. दीज आर कॉल्ड एरर्स. दीज आर कॉल्ड
एरर्स. एरर्स.
There is called plugin. Go to the plugin. There is called name on object variable. Automatically error will be shown here. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Yes, sir. The last one is
I want to see that the factors are independent. So for that, what I will do, I will select all these variables and to check the independent, go to the plugin and go for draw covariance. So now the डिजाइन पार्ट इज रेडी. मैंने कॉन्फर्मेटरी डिजाइन कर लिया हूं. मुझे चेक करना है टेस्ट करना है इंटरप्रेट करना है. दोबारा इसको बताऊं हाउ आई डिड दैट द डिजाइनिंग पार्ट. कैन एक्सप्लेन अगेन.
या वन मोर टाइम सर प्लीज इफ यू कैन रिपीट.
ओके 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 न्यू. मैं इसको रिड्यूस कर भी कर रहा हूं. फर्स्ट इज यू सिलेक्ट द
नॉट द एंटायर
कंस्ट्रक्ट साइज.
Sorry, sir, not the entire part. That last one you did, the variance, that thing we wanted to. That's it. Not the entire part.
Oh, delete kar liya, dobara karna padega.
No problem.
No problem.
No problem, sir. You can continue.
Okay, dobara. Let me explain again so that it will be repeat. Yeah? So first, select your events. Then, first factor brand, I have, let me, four items. सेकेंड फैक्टर आई एम हैविंग थ्री आइटम. मैं क्लिक कर रहा हूँ माउस में. थ्री आइटम. क्लियर. देन इसको मुझे क्या करना है रोटेट करना है कि मुझे एक साइज में करना है. सो देयर इज अ कॉल्ड रोटेट हियर. देयर इज सिंबल रोटेट. आई विल रोटेट लाइक दिस. देन आई हैव टू मूव द ऑब्जेक्ट टुगेदर. क्लियर. वन टू थ्री four and five. What is the second step? Anybody, what is second step?
Pin code to the variable.
File ko read karna फाइल रीड करना है तो गो टू डाटा फाइल। डाटा मेरे पास कहां पर है? डाटा मेरे पास है ट्रिपलाइडियम फाइल में। आई ऑलरेडी सेड वन फाइल सीएफए एंड एसीएम डाटा। ओके, वो ऑटोमेटिक रीड कर रहा है यहां पर, क्लिक ओके। व्हेन यू क्लिक द ओके ऑटोमेटिकली देयर इज अ लिस्ट ऑफ वेरिएबल, यू गॉट ऑल द लिस्ट हियर, क्लियर?
यस सर।
फर्स्ट फैक्टर इज कॉल्ड A1, A2, A3. तो मैंने क्या किया, आई पुट A1, देन आई पुट A2, देन आई पुट A3, देन सेकंड A4. क्योंकि मैं कोडिंग इस हिसाब से अगर कर लूंगा फैक्टर के बाद तो मेरे लिए इजी हो जाएगा। एक्सपर्ट फैक्टर के बाद मैं इसको कोडिंग कर दिया कि ये ब्रांड है, ब्रांड के अंदर ये चार आइटम था, क्लियर? सेकंड वन इज कॉल्ड, लेट बी सेकंड वन इज योर बी इज हियर, बी ओके B4, देन और बी वेर इज बी B3, कोडिंग मैंने जो लिया था चार फैक्टर का, B2 एंड B1 एंड B2, एंड सेकेंड आई गो फॉर C फैक्टर, C1, C2 एंड व्हाट नेक्स्ट वन, C3, वेर इज C3, C3. Now next is called D2, then D1, D3, D4, D1 and D3. And next I'll go for, because don't take E, because already error ka naam E hoga, so don't take E as a coding. Then you change, let it be K1, K2 and K3. Then what is the brand ka kya tha hamara? Infra. What next? Anybody? Events. And
promotion. Promo. Value-added service.
And value-added service. Now, what next? That this is missing. This error is missing. Go to the plugin. Name unobserved variable. Automatically, you see all unobserved variables are identified. And the last part is, when you apply conformative factor analysis, you have to assume that the factor should be independent. For that, what I will do, select each factor and go to the plugin and draw covariance. Now, you save test one, model one. Mera model one save ho gaya. Any doubt up to this? Can I proceed now?
Yes, sir. No doubt.
Now, the second part is, I have to... Okay. Okay. The most important part is, CFA make, there is not to be cross-loading. Matlab, agar ek item is construct mein reh raha hai, the same item should not be licensed in other construct. So in CFA, the most important thing is, if you apply CFA, there is no cross-loading. Aapko dekha hoga, when you apply EFA, some items are lies in factor 1 and also factor 4. Okay, there is a cross-loading. So if you apply the CFA, that problem will be removed. So that's why most of the researchers are using CFA to validate the result. Okay. Now, next problem is called, how to find out significance. फर्स्ट आई विल चेक द मॉडल इज फिट और नॉट। पहले काम क्या किया मैंने, मॉडल को डिजाइन किया। पहले काम क्या किया मैंने, मॉडल को
डिजाइन किया।
अब सेकंड इज, आई हैव टू सी दैट मॉडल इज फिट और नॉट। जो मैंने एक्सप्लोरेटरी फैक्टर लिया हूं, वो मेरा मॉडल फिट होगा या नहीं होगा। फॉर दैट केस आई हैव टू गो फॉर थ्री थिंग्स। व्हाट आर द थ्री थिंग्स? आई हैव टू कैलकुलेट एब्सोल्यूट फिट इंडेक्स, रिलेटिव फिट इंडेक्स एंड कंपैरेटिव फिट इंडेक्स। क्लियर? व्हाट आर द थ्री थिंग्स रिक्वायर्ड? Absolute fit index, then relative fit index, and comparative fit index. In absolute fit index, I want to find out chi square value, RMSE value, GFI value, HGFI. What is GFI? Goodness of fit index. This is the value we have to calculate. Okay. Now, if you want to say what is the meaning of that, then it will take one lecture. So I will just explain these are the things required. Please take the snapshot. So take the model fit. I want to see these things. What are the things? What is the first one? What is the first one I have to see? Anybody? What is the morality point? Less than 3 is means morally fit. जो आपने ये test किया था, जो exploratory किया था, that is fit. Okay, it can be generalized for the more population. But the value should be 3 to 5. If it is greater than 5, then means your model is not fit. You have to improve the model by taking more data, or you have to see the problem. There may be polynarity. Second, what is the C5 value required? C5 means cumulative index. What is the minimum value required? 0.80. And what is the best one? Greater than 0.9. Clear?
Nice.
What is GFI value required? Greater than 0.95. AGFI greater than 0.80. And SRMR less than 0.09. And RMC, this is called, we have required less than 0.05 is good. And PC close is greater than 0.5. Please write, it's called snapshot. This is required now to check that whether your model is fit or unfit. Now, how to do that? These are the recommended values. You take again, you take the snapshot. Snapshot le liye apne, kitna chahiye aapko? Jab aap paper likhenge, pehle design ko dikhane ke baad, then you give this out, this output, whether the model is fit or not. Okay, can I go for the MOS again?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, यहाँ क्या लिखा गया? क्या लिखा गया यहाँ पर? There is a term. Please see what is written here. Calculate.
Estimates.
Estimate. So now first thing, there are 3 steps for factor analysis. First, develop the exploratory factor analysis. Based upon that, design your diagram. Then third thing is check the model fit. Whether your model you have explored the true factor is fit or not. To do that, there is a terminology called first go to the analysis property. Yang a property hoga. Then I go to the output. I want standard estimates. I want modification indices. I want factor score, covariance. Please click this 4-1. What are the 4-1? Pehle kisko click kiya maine? Standard estimates,
standardized
factor score and covariance. These 4 marks, nothing else. Then calculated estimates. Agar yahan par value show ho raha hai na, yahan par image show ho raha hai na?
Yes, sir.
It means aapka model run ho gaya hai, koi problem nahi hai. Design mein koi problem nahi hai, estimation mein koi problem nahi hai. Agar ye run nahi hoga, there may be some problem. Clear? The model मेरा run हो गया, I have to see now कि मेरा model fit है ना नहीं है, then there is a call view test. Is it visible to everyone?
Yes, sir.
In view test, please go to the model fit. यहाँ model fit लिखा जा रहा है ना? Hello.
हाँ जी sir.
Now see what is the chi square value? 1.613. What is the minimum value required?
3.
Less than 3. Okay, so now it means first condition is satisfied. Chi square value is less than 3. What is GFA value? 0.970 is greater than 9 is good. AGFI greater than 0.9 is good. Then, kitna value hua? Yahan par ek dekhna hai, chi square dekhna hai, GFI dekhna hai. Then AGFI देखना है, RMR is less than 0.05, it is again good. Then last one is called RMSCA, less than 0.05 is good. And so it means all 5 things are satisfied. Chi square mean, GFI, AGFI, and RMC. Now see, I will explain through the PPT. Wait, now see. What is the minimum required? कितना वैल्यू चाहिए हमको चाई स्क्वायर मीन? हेलो, इज इट विजिबल टू एवरीवन?
यस सर.
मॉडल फिट के लिए कितना वैल्यू चाहिए? 2 इज प्रेफर्ड, 2.5 इज कंसीडरेड. हमारा कितना वहां पर हमारा कितना वैल्यू आया था?
1.6.
इज सो इट मींस फर्स्ट इज सैटिस्फाइड. क्लियर?
यस सर.
और सेकंड वन इज व्हाट अबाउट GFI? 0.965 कितना होना चाहिए? इधर होना चाहिए 0.90 से अबव होना चाहिए. व्हाट अबाउट माय रिजल्ट? हाउ मच?
0.970.
It is okay? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, third, what is AGFI? कितना होना चाहिए?
0.946 से अबव.
कितना होना चाहिए? 0.90. मेरे रिजल्ट कितना आया? 0.958. सेटिस्फाइड? क्लियर?
यस सर.
नाउ नेक्स्ट, व्हाट अबाउट दिस वन?
सीएफआई.
व्हाट अबाउट सीएफआई? कितना होना चाहिए?
0.9 से अबव.
What it says that? It says that if it gets to 0.95, then sample size is adequate. Now, see my result. What is the CFI now?
0.944.
So, it is also satisfied. Then next, what will you go for? Second. What about RMSCA? Kitna hona chahiye? 0.05 से कम होना चाहिए. व्हाट अबाउट माय रिजल्ट? आरएमएससीए हाउ मच? दिस वन 0.05 से कम आ रहा है. सो इट मींस दैट माय मॉडल इज फिट. क्लियर?
यस सर.
नाउ देन गो टू द एस्टीमेट. दैट इज कॉल्ड एस्टीमेट. एन एस्टीमेट सी ब्रांड के अंदर में कितना वेरिएबल लिए थे हमने? कितना वेरिएबल लिए थे?
5 वेरिएबल.
4 वेरिएबल लिए थे. And all are significant. Star आ रहा है ना?
Yes sir.
It means तो कोई भी factor brand के अंदर में जो भी statement लिए थे that all are intact and we cannot be deleted anyone. So these all four should be related into the brand. Okay? In what about second? Infra में कितना लिए थे हमने? 4. Significant आया नहीं आया? Event में significant आया? Okay? आपने बोलोगे सर एक में star नहीं आ रहा है तो एक by default हम 1 लेते हैं. Then it's a measurement karte hai, so it means it's also significant. So is there anybody whose p value is not significant? Hello?
No sir. Yeah. No sir.
So what is the conclusion? Conclusion is that my model is fit. So whatever factor we explored from the factor analysis, it will also fit in the confirmatory. So it means my scale is validated. Now second, kya likha hai?
Standardized regression weights.
These are called loading values. These are called loading values. Okay. Now second, these are called regression values. Clear? Brand infra. How? What is the impact? Infra has a 0.15% impact on brand, followed by 9% impact on the events, 0.7% impact on the brand promo, and value-added services. How much?
0.10.
It means relation between factor to factor, brand and infra ka andar mein 0.150 aa raha hai, which is highly impacted. The relation between high relation between brand and infra. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Now, then go to the correlation within brand, which is highly correlated. Brand infra mein sabse high correlated kon aa raha hai? Highly correlated kon sa aa raha hai? Brand and
infra.
It means if you develop the infrastructure, automatically the brand value will be increases, then people will be more interested towards your product. Okay? Now, now I will see. You go for all, now what is GFI? Already there. What is GFI? Meaning is there. Okay. Do you require this PPT?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. We need this PPT also and earlier session PPT also.
I already, earlier session come in, already bhej chuka hu. Hello.
Okay, sir.
Hello. Second part is I want to go for the validity. First is model is fit ho gaya, model analysis ho gaya. Now go to the validity. For validity, hello. Any doubt?
No, sir. Continue.
Okay. Now second part is I want to check the validity. So what is the first thing? Anybody? What is the first thing? First, apply EFA. Second, design the graph based upon EFA. Then check the model fit. Model fit ke liye kya kya check karenge hum log? Chi square, GFI, AGFI, CFI, RMSCA, and PC close. If all values are satisfied, then you can say that the model is fit. Whatever the exploratory factor among the IATA, that can be generalized. That scale is validated. Then you check the loading value and significant value. मैं दोबारा इसको analysis के बारे बता लेता हूँ, so that it will be clear to all of you. Okay, go to the estimate. What is the first one? पहले क्या देखा आप check करेंगे? क्या लिखा यहाँ पर? Hello. Regression weights. Now see all the items are significant. Star आ रहा है ना?
Yes sir.
अगर मान के चलो A3 में स्टार नहीं आता तो क्या करेंगे हम लोग? A3 में स्टार नहीं आता है, व्हाट आई विल डू, आई विल एक्सप्लेन. देन मैं क्या करूंगा, यहां पर A3 को डिलीट करूंगा एंड अगेन आई हैव टू एस्टिमेट. क्लियर?
ओके
यस. हेलो यस सर.
इसका मतलब है अगर ये स्टार नहीं आ रहा, मतलब है ये सिग्निफिकेंट फैक्टर नहीं है, तो इसको इसको डिलीट करूंगा, अगेन चेक करूंगा, अगर फिट हो गया देन वी कैन कंक्लूड दैट इन एक्सप्लोरेटरी फैक्टर एनालिसिस दैट 23 आइटम्स आर देयर, बट इन कंफर्मेटरी, व्हाइल कंफर्मेटरी ओनली 22 आइटम्स आर रिमेनिंग, ओनली वन फैक्टर इज नॉट, दैट्स वी आर गोइंग टू डिलीट इट. क्लियर? सो द ऑब्जेक्टिव ऑफ CFA इज टू फाइंड आउट वेदर द फैक्टर्स आर वी सिग्निफिकेंट और नॉट, ऑल द आइटम्स आर सिग्निफिकेंट और नॉट. That can be checked. Now go to the output. Now see. Now here what happened? I got all the significant things. Clear? Hello. What about this? This is the loading values, and these are the covariance value, which is the highly covariant covariance. Brand from kitna aa raha hai? 0.150. Now tell me, do you think the high value of covariance or low value of covariance? Anybody? Can you want high variance, high variable or low variable, low value estimates?
High value, sir.
Low value.
Because we want that is independent and it is significant also. Now this is correlation between brand factor to factor. This much, sir. हमको यही table चाहिए and research paper के लिए हमको इसका output और estimate का this output चाहिए. तीन चीज चाहिए. Diagram, the model fit का significant value. हेलो, हमको तीन चीज चाहिए, एक डायग्राम चाहिए. नाउ लिसन, वी वांट थ्री थिंग्स, दिस आर द आइटम्स, वी वांट थ्री थिंग्स. फर्स्ट आई वांट दिस वन, कैन यू इसको बना सकते हो ना अभी? व्हाट इज रिकमेंडेड वैल्यू, व्हाट इज आवर वैल्यू. क्लियर? हेलो, कोई तो बैठे करो मेरे भाई. फर्स्ट इज डायग्राम बनाया मैंने, डायग्राम बनाया, बनाने के बाद देन मॉडल फिट को मैंने एक टेबल एनालिसिस लिखा मैंने, एंड आई से दैट ऑल द वेरिएबल्स आर अकॉर्डिंग टू द जस्टिफिकेशन रिकमेंडेड वैल्यू, आई से द मॉडल इज फिट. देन आई गो फॉर द एस्टिमेट्स. इन एस्टिमेट आई विल ओनली एक्सप्लेन अबाउट दिस टेबल. व्हिच वन? आई विल ओनली एक्सप्लेन अबाउट दिस टेबल. क्लियर? एंड आई विल सी दैट whether all the items are significant or not. If the p-value are given the star, it is significant. Now next, what are the next one? Next, I want to explain. Now next, I want to explain the, what is third step? Third step is called validity. What is third step?
Validity.
There are four validity are there. One is called face validity, convergent validity, discriminant validity, nominological validity, and third one is called reliability. That is called CR. So, ये पांच चीज चाहिए. ये चीज हम लोग जो during SCM में पढ़ेंगे. SCM के लिए जितना मेरा item के same चीज रहेगा, ये चीज हम लोग करेंगे. फिर भी बता देता हूँ what is validity. For the first one, first thing is that before running CFA model, find out what is the published result from previous studies. Retest and post-test. Okay. What is face validity? Face validity means the extent of which the content of the item is consistent with the construct definition and solely on research judgment. हमें हम जो judgment लिए थे कि infra में रहेगा, ये technological में रहेगा, event में रहेगा, अगर same item और उसमें रह रहा है, तो कैंसर दैट देयर इज अ फेस वैलिडिटी. क्लियर? जो आइटम हमने सोचे थे इस फैक्टर में रहेगा, इफ सेम आइटम विल लाई इन दैट फैक्टोरियल फैक्टर, वी कैन से दैट दिस इज फेस वैलिडिटी. सो द वैलिडिटी पार्ट एंड रिलायबिलिटी पार्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन ड्यूरिंग द स्ट्रक्चर्ड मॉडलिंग. ओके, अप टू दिस एनी डाउट ये बहुत हाई हो जाएगा. मैं जब एसटीएम पढ़ाऊंगा कोई चीज पढ़ाऊंगा. ओके, सो लेट मी एक्सप्लेन, रिपीट कर रहा हूं मैं क्या पढ़ाया मैंने. What is the first step? First, research problem, then identification of variable, then anybody? Hello?
EFA.
Then apply EFA. In apply EFA, EFA. What are the things we've done? In EFA, we calculated front bank alpha for reliability, then AMO for sample adequacy, then Bartlett or factors are independent, then eigenvalue to see the factors are greater than one, it is called factor. Then loading is correlation between the statement to the factor. Clear? Based upon this, we have extracted the factor and its item. Factor and item. Clear?
Yes, sir.
After that, what we discussed? We discussed CFA. In CFA, our objective is to validate the scale. For that, you have to design based upon your EFA. Clear? Then test the model fit or not.
Yes,
for model fit, what are things required? Required chi-square value, GFI value, GFI value, CFA value, RMSTA, and C-close. A child square should be between 3 to 5, less than 3 is good. GFI is greater than 0.90, AGFI is greater than 0.90, and RMSTA should be less than 0.05, and CFI should be also greater than 0.90. If all are satisfied, then we check that the model, the factor and the item, if it is P value significant or star, we can consider that whatever item we have generated in EFA, that is validated and to generalize the data. Any doubt?
No, sir.
Now see. और more explanation, जो चीज आपको पढ़ाया था यहाँ लिखा, क्या लिखा पढ़ा, तो क्या लिखा यहाँ पर? Estimate क्या कहा यहाँ पर? These are called on-stand estimates or regression weights. If the p value asterisk हो रहा है, asterisk हो रहा है, 0.05 से कम हो रहा है, then it means these factors are be significant and the items will be significant. Okay? These are the loading I have already explained. Now to go for more details for reliability and validity and SEM, tomorrow I will take the three things: structural modeling and validity and structural reliability. Any doubt after this?
Any doubt? Can I apply? Do I apply? No, sir. It is clear. No, sir. Clear. Now, see, these are the covariance value. These are items. Jo aa raha hai na, the covariance value hai. These are regression weights. Okay, these are regression weights. If any value less than 0.5,
please delete there only, but now see, all are good. Okay, and with this, now see the which is the highest one. This is the error coefficient, and this is the error variance. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, sir.
I think ये आपको थोड़ा high हो गया जी.
नहीं सर, high नहीं हुआ, बहुत अच्छा गया है सर.
It was very very good, sir.
Okay. So tomorrow I will start from SEM, then I will go for validity, then it will construct reliability. So any doubt? So for more details, I am having my YouTube channel. Even YouTube channel, you can find the CFA SEM. वहाँ पर मेरा already lecture है. Okay, तो आप वहाँ पर भी देख के same variable जो मैं आपको दिया हूँ ना, वो भी वहाँ पर मैं analysis किया हूँ. You can check and practice.
दास सर. सर वो आप जो YouTube चैनल है आपका, उसका लिंक सर उसमें ग्रुप में पेस्ट कर दीजिएगा प्लीज.
हाँ मैं कर दूंगा, मैं उसमें बिब्लियोमेट्रिक भी होगा, SLR भी होगा, फैक्टर एनालिसिस भी होगा, CFA होगा, जितना भी लेक्चर मैंने पढ़ाया हूँ और भी अदर एफडीपी में भी सारा लेक्चर होगा, आप यू कैन गो थ्रू दैट, दैट विल बी बेटर.
थैंक यू सर.
एनी क्वेश्चंस फॉर पार्टिसिपेंट्स? अजय सर अगर होते तो बोलते व्हाट इज जीएफआई, जीएफआई का डेफिनेशन, जीएफआई का इक्वेशन, जीएफआई का सॉल्यूशन. For management student, we require one thing. The, what is the minimum value required? For more details, I can also explain. But now, the, I say in the audience that they have started from their face. Okay, but Ajay sir, his strength is that they start from the theory equation and they calculate GFA value over there.
That's why I am not giving any lecture, sir.
Okay. हम लोग सो पीस में है, बड़ा अजय सर तो मास्टर पीस है. एनी क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम योर पार्टिसिपेंट प्लीज आस्क, बिकॉज आई एम डेफिनेटली आंसर योर क्वेरीज. एंड आई हैव ऑलरेडी शेयर्ड सम ऑफ द फाइल, पीडीएफ फाइल टू द पार्टिसिपेंट्स, प्लीज गो थ्रू दैट. एंड माय रिक्वेस्ट इज प्लीज प्रैक्टिस एटलीस्ट एमओएस पर प्रैक्टिस करो सीएफए में. टुमारो व्हेन आई गो फॉर एचसीएम इट विल बी इजी फॉर यू. एनी क्वेश्चन? अगर क्वेश्चन नहीं होगा ना तो लग रहा है कि आपको समझ नहीं आया. मंजुला मैडम जी, एनी क्वेश्चन?
सर ऑलरेडी मिस्टर फारूक